Let's turn this again. My name's Keith, and I'm the founder of SoundSue, which is the Surrey Area Network of Substance Users. I'll put my name up here on the board. And the gentleman right here, Ron, he's the president of the group. Basically filming the back of your head. They're filming what's going on up here so we can get the word out to people that need to hear about what's going on at SoundSue, right? And then there's we have a SoundSue executive, basically our steering committee. Okay, and on that committee is Jen.
I'm the only one here, right?
What?
Anybody?
You got nominated. And that's it right at the moment. That's it for the moment.
That's okay.
Anyways, before we start doing anything, what we do is we go around the room, we introduce ourselves with first name and why you came here, how you found out about it, if it was just a pizza or someone said, hey, it's kindly that you would help them fill it out so that we get an idea of what your interests are. So then we can start steering, we can steer meetings to words, different things, interests, etc.
I think I'm like a big chalkboard here.
Oh yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. So anyways, all right, you might break my arm off. All right, great. Well, anyway, so this, all right, so what we do here at SoundSue is like we try to individually, you know, our voices aren't being heard, right? All they want to do is have a voice that that someone hears and that it feels validated and that you feel heard, right? So collectively, what happens here is we have some topics that we sort of throw out, and that doesn't mean that that's the only thing we're talking about. We'll go wherever the conversation, wherever the group goes. This meeting lasts for about an hour and 20 minutes, so about 8:20. So if you can hold on to your seats for that long. And if you haven't signed in yet, please do, because at the end, we value your time. So, oh, my fries are gone. No, everybody, so what you say here, and as I said prior to, this meeting is filmed. And we're basically filming the backs of your heads, so we're not here to help you in any way, or, you know, if you're on Crime Stoppers or whatever, it doesn't really matter, but what it is to hear what you have to say. Okay, is everybody okay with that? If you're not okay with that, there's the door, because this is what we do here, right? And this is an opportunity. Everybody says, I want to be heard, I want to be heard, I want to be heard, and then we have the opportunity to be heard. Everybody's not down for it, so there we go.
Patrick's here.
Patrick, come on in, buds. Sign in with Ron, grab a chair at the back of the table, pizza's on the table, pop's on the counter, coffee's there. If you have to do anything else, let me know. Well, Lepkin just arrived, atta boy.
James is on his way too. He
okay, good.
To see his exploit.
Okay, great. Whatever it takes, come on in.
That's
too
bad, Patrick.
This is the amount of overdoses that are going on, that are continuing to go on. And I need you guys to tell me about it. So who wants to start? What do you know? What don't you know? What do you want to know? Doug?
Well, where do you want to start?
I want you to tell me how many overdoses since January. Roughly.
Oh, my God. January.
Do you know that we're approaching 300?
Are you serious?
Province wide.
What? Overdoses? Those are just the ones I've reversed. I don't know.
Yeah.
You only count
the ones you're sticking the needle in?
I only count the ones that I poked. Yeah.
Okay, how many have you poked since January?
I don't count them.
How many have you poked?
Well, since January, I've poked 30.
30, okay. So Doug's score ticket is 30.
Well, my number is 122.
So. 122 from last year?
Since I've been carrying that kit.
Okay, so 122. That's since you've been carrying, right? Yeah, that's just nasty, eh? One guy carrying a naloxone kit, eh? 122 people.
Oh
yeah.
Doug, is that Is that the total of the amount of people you poked, or have you poked that person more than one time?
I only count them for once, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just making sure.
Yeah.
I did one guy 3 times in one day.
Yeah, you can be
pulled,
yeah.
Oh, I've done 6 in one day.
It's crazy.
It's
six
crazy,
on one person
yeah.
in one day?
So, what do you think the answer is? If you had
medical heroin.
What?
For the government to actually provide the medical heroin that's needed to prevent the overdoses.
Doctor scored points here. You think? Medical grade heroin. No buff.
Because then there's no fentanyl, then there's no carfentanil.
And then there's no black market.
Exactly.
Free money,
huh?
Because I don't have free money.
Why is that?
Well,
neither do I. Neither do I. But you might have cancer.
You have every opportunity to.
Well, there you go. There you go. You can go use dope, and then you can go get medical heroin. There you go. It's a choice, right? But what's happening is because of this stuff, you know, people are dying, right? It's epidemic. It's a medical epidemic. It's just like the Black Plague in Europe, right? Or
no governing body.
Yeah, exactly. So there's nobody regulating it. There's nobody curtailing it.
There's nobody
monitoring it, right?
Yeah, there's no monitoring of what goes into the heroin that's sold on the street.
Yeah, like an egg beater and in a pail, and that's what you might be getting, the good shit. You might be getting the stuff that put you in the grave, right?
Yeah.
No one knows, and it's not color-coded, so you go, oh, well, there's too much in one end, and... You know, you open up your flop or a flop of baggy or whatever, and next thing you know, it's like
right
straight up because it's all purple. And you know, purple was, if it was color coded, it'd be awesome. All buff has to be yellow, all real dope purple, and all synthetics yellow or
green.
Blue or green. So then when you get it in there, you know what you got.
If you're like me, you take a girl with you and tell her you're going to give her some free dope, and then after you got it mixed up, you give her a point. One, two, three. That's what he does.
Yeah.
Honest to God.
Yeah. 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 Exactly.
He's trying himself.
Yeah. No, exactly. You get free dope and then watch what happens. What's happening. So, I don't know. There's so many different answers here.
Basically in heroin?
It's in everything. Like, we just started to talk about heroin, right?
Mostly in heroin, right?
No. What drug would you say that most of it's buff? Like, would heroin be the first one?
Yeah.
Crack?
No, crack cocaine has more buff than anything.
Yeah?
There is such little amounts of cocaine left in crack cocaine that it's... you got 90% buff, 10%
and
crack.
With the buff, you're talking about buff and carfentanil, fentanyl, whatever else, right? All the synthetic crap, right? Pinky wormer, all the fun stuff.
Yeah.
The laxatives.
That was the one that I think, but it happened.
Yeah. So I mean, it's not just limited to
crack would be the number one fill for buff.
For buff, or
then you're.
Oh yeah, very good.
So we're going.
Just with the real stuff.
Three. What's three?
Math.
4. Weed. What?
How do you buff weed?
Are you kidding me? Do you think you can't put fentanyl in mixed in with weed?
You could mix fentanyl with water.
It's pointless with the fentanyl. Sprinkle weed,
isn't it? You could mix fentanyl in water and spray your pot plants with that, and then be dropping.
You used to spray pot plants with Coca Cola, make them when they hung them.
So they're sticky,
and they would make it wetter, it's really good. No, it's actually just sprayed the Coca Cola.
Yeah, that's like root beer kush and cotton candy kush.
Yeah.
All it is watered down.
Yeah, that's all it is.
The only other way to cheat on weed is to make it heavier than it is.
Yep. Well, yeah, it's like marijuana helper, right? You turn an ounce into a pound. Okay, so there you go. So, okay, now that goes speaks to the second sort of part where it'll go to. Street drugs, where are they now? Like, where'd they go? Like, what's left out there you can possibly get that's like pure? Or close to pure. That's not been tampered with.
The only way you're going to do that is by making it into dope.
That speaks to the fact that...
The odd heroin. I know a couple
of people that fell
into heroin.
Odd heroin. Did you shave?
Yes, you shaved.
Oh my God. Try to go on a dot. Want it?
I have one more friend at work. Can I go get her?
Yeah.
I thought I was going
to go. No? Where's Ron?
You went the other way.
Okay, all right. So, basically now the predominantly all drugs are been tampered with and there's nothing.
The only way to get pure is either grow those plants yourself or to make the methamphetamine yourself.
Right.
I know a couple people that sell this heroin and no fentanyl in it.
Sorry?
I know a couple people that sell heroin and no fentanyl.
How many people do you know that don't?
Everybody else.
Everybody else. There you go. I know a couple people and then everybody else, right? It's like a couple of people and everybody else, right? That's the way it looks nowadays, right? Here's the real stuff.
And there's the big picture.
And yeah, this is the big picture is what's going on. It's like, and the shitty part is that no one can sort of stand up to the fact that I'm not going to tell everybody, you know, push back to the industry and say, okay, all you dealers, we're gonna go on strike. We're not doing any more of your synthetic dope until you come back to the table with some real stuff. And they look at you and go, ha, ha, ha.
Yeah, right.
Exactly,
We'll find somewhere else to sell our synthetic.
Well, yeah. If everybody went on strike, that's pretty much what would have to happen. Okay? So basically it'd be pretty hard to find. Like probably, I would say, for 1/25, or you know, like a very small percentage of people would have real dope anymore. Anywhere, doesn't matter if it's street level or like, you know, high bottom or low bottom. You know what I mean?
I saw a documentary on heroin. It gets top every time you change hands.
Yes, and more expensive.
Yeah.
Like, why did they disappear? Why is all this synthetic stuff coming online?
Cheaper.
Price, right? Price.
The reason comes down to the dollar.
Yeah, price. Supply and demand. Supply versus demand, price. And the price goes lower with the synthetics than it does for the real stuff, right? So if you're getting a point of real heroin or a couple points, it's more expensive than what? What can you get for the same price of 2 points of pure heroin? Hmm. Anybody know?
It's not really true. When I first started doing that 4 years ago, it was $55. That was about 5 years ago.
So $50 for a what?
A cube. No, pure fentanyl.
Oh, yeah. Okay. And now what's the cost? Anybody know? Has it gone down? Or has it gone up?
I don't know.
So
it's
gone up, I think, by a lot.
Yeah, that's still the same price. That's still pretty much a point, too.
Right? 2.5 points for $50, right?
Yeah, but Q down, well, back then it was actually down. It was before, everything was bought from fentanyl. It was $40.
Yeah, frequent flyers, right? Does that come with air miles?
Yeah.
Or just high miles?
Yeah.
Okay, alright, so now. Alright, so that's enough about that. You got all this? Okay.
Okay, so your name's Pete?
Yeah.
Okay.
Name? Okay, what about the response to somebody overdosing?
Okay.
Is there holes in the system? Do you want to sit down? Do you want to need a chair?
I have
go use the bathroom.
Sorry?
In the bathroom. Here, I'm sure.
Oh, is there somebody in there?
No.
Yes.
Okay, go down the hall to the left. Okay, so response to people overdosing.
Here we go.
Okay, what's going on? Doug, you're one of the responders. So how does it go on in here? People start yelling out, Narcan, Naloxone.
Yeah.
You know, someone's down.
Yeah. The front room could give you some stats. They keep records of stats.
Yes, I know that.
I don't keep a record. I just...
No, we do our job. We just do our deal, right?
Can you give me some?
That's the dead guy I was talking about. There he
Everybody
is.
Everybody said that you were dead.
Apparently not.
Now he's gonna be dead.
Okay. There you go, Ben.
Alright, so okay, so.
I was great.
Do a smoke break.
I need better though.
I'm very worried.
Okay, how about this? Let's go for a break right now.
From prior thing, or is this
a recent thing? No, it's a recent thing. Actually, it's over the years, I think. Well, a bit old. But, okay, so, alright, so response to someone overdosing. You should know this. What?
I was on crack.
Oh, you're on my. So you're on the receiving end of the lockstep.
Yeah, somebody stole my kit, too. They dug my shit before I was even out the door.
What happens out here is that somebody yells Narcan or Naloxone or whatever, they come running. How many people come running? With kids? With or without kids?
At least three.
Well, three people with kids?
No guys.
Nope.
Is that accurate, Doug?
Not yet. Oh.
My husband's next.
They don't break my clothes.
I break down.
Yeah?
Can I break your phone?
I don't. No, I'm not with them.
Okay, so roughly three people with kids?
Usually, yeah. I've seen it.
So that's nine, what was that?
Let's be honest.
Six miles?
Let's make it two.
Yeah, six miles.
Two? Okay.
I'd say two.
Always two, sometimes.
Sure, two. Always.
Two to three.
So six to nine vials.
Yeah, so you got six to nine vials going on?
No.
The RCB has a
good. Yeah.
4 to 6.
Okay, so what do you find more effective? The nasal.
In a spray.
In a lock.
I haven't even heard of it.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Yeah.
I've been down here for like a couple months. So
yeah.
I've only been down here twice, three times.
Okay.
In the last
Roger,
couple months. And
brother,
So, what do you guys find more effective? Doug? Would you rather have the needle and locks in a vial, or would you have a nasal spray?
I'd rather have nasal spray.
Oh,
yeah.
Pull up
the
pocket.
No poking involved, no loading. Oh, they slam it into their ass.
Well, whatever.
So, how many doses are in a nasal spray kit?
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
So we're trying to focus here. So Patrick, okay. So
I'm not sure. I don't know how many.
Okay. It's funny how the guys that are, you know. Okay. Anyways, it'd be easier if everybody was carrying one of these.
Do they hand those out?
Yeah.
Only the police.
If they were available, they'd want one.
Only the police
can have one. I'm just going to ask.
Who wouldn't want one? Who wouldn't want one?
Oh.
Who would want one?
Of course.
Yeah, okay, all right. So that's something to
So quick.
Good one. Okay, we'll get that. Okay, so this one. Okay, so what else? So basically, so refitting, retooling the people here with the nasal spray, something a little faster, quicker, easier to use than trying to fuddle a little around with the loading the rig and then putting it in someone, right? Although we're pretty good at doing that, right? Well, hey, shitty lighting, and you deploy that rig, you're done.
Yeah.
You only get two rigs in a kit, right?
Three.
One
for each
vial. Yeah, and then so you miss it, boom, there goes one.
Exactly.
You know, and then so how are you gonna deploy three vials if you got two rigs?
Exactly. Hope you don't need.
I tried to smash.
Yeah,
nope.
Hopefully.
Can you carry them around loaded?
No, they're no good after,
you know,
after they're loaded. They're no good.
Yeah, no. Oh.
So they only last.
Okay, all right. So
they've got a short lifespan.
Right. They have no
air exposure.
Okay, let's go out of order here. Okay, this one here is kind of interesting, guys. Listen up. It's a program that's being dispensed in the downtown east side. It's called Spikes on Bikes, and it's supported by Vancouver Coastal Health Authority, Vanview, and Portland Hotel Society, right? So I said to Shane, I said, why can't Sansu, the Lookout Society, and Fraser Health Authority do the exact same thing here? And what it is, basically, you have teams of two trained people, and they have backpacks with harm reduction materials and the loxin. So basically, almost like a street nurse room. You ride around, and you get paid for like a four-hour shift to go and ride around and load people up, or also, because you're in teams of two, to if someone's going down. Right? You have naloxone.
Someone's breathing and somebody's...
And you get a
do they make you take a course and all that shit?
The only course
you
need...
have to be like a nurse?
No, no. The only course you would have to take is like an hour, a naloxone course, how to deploy a naloxone kit, okay?
What if we already took the course?
So then you're done. You're good. You're good to go.
I want to do it.
You're good to roll. So what happens is...
Are they still hiring people in the
back? So hold on. No, still on. Okay, so RCMP do what?
Nothing.
All right, so what they have is they have seized bicycles, right? So they have them, and then what happens, people don't come to get them, and then they auction them off. So we have the bikes here.
I can see why we don't have any series.
Like an endless supply of bikes, right? Now, hold on. Yeah, tell us. Rogers. Bell. Shaw, Chivado, who am I missing?
Chatter,
Freedom,
Kudo,
Felicity. Okay, so what do these guys got?
Any phone.
What?
Any phone will call
911. What?
Wind is called
Freedom. Oh, Freedom wants to know. Their phone's
called 911. So phones and?
You don't need a chip for a meter.
Internet.
Chargers, right? So you got bikes plus the phones, okay? And what does Fraser Health Authority have, or Fraser Health, or
money,
or
how are you
BCCDC? Okay, so kits plus H or you got the bikes. So if the bikes go missing or stolen or whatever, we'll get more. We're gonna spray paint them like fluorescent freaking orange. Actually, we're gonna spray paint them white with a flat can. So what happens is, when you're off the road, what's the idea of a naloxone kit? Keep someone alive long enough to the first responders get there, right?
Yeah.
Right? Because other than that, they'd be dead. So if we paint the bikes or get reflective tape, I've got a buddy's got reflective tape, so that if the first responders coming down this street and you can turn your bike upside down, because like on the ski hill, when someone is injured, you just walk up the hill in front and put your skis in the snow like this. So people didn't fucking come ripping over top of you while you're like in the snowbank, right? Same idea. So if you're helping somebody, you turn your bike upside down and it's glowing white and they start shining their, whatever first responder is, paramedics, whatever, hold on. That way they'll see you, right? Okay, so now you're in teams of two, you got a phone that's charged. The only phone number you can call is 911, which is all you need to call, right? Right, okay? Now you got a backpack and a helmet, the Fraser Health Authority and BCCDC, so you have naloxone kits and harm reduction supplies, right? So Sansu, what do they have?
Cool jackets.
The training.
Yeah, that's it. Sansu's got the people. Okay, train people.
I got a problem with white bikes, though, especially in the snow.
It's reflective tape, bro. All we do is forget painting the bike, just put white reflective tape that you see on the back of the cop cars. We'll even rip it off the cop cars and throw it on your bike.
Well, no, we won't do that.
There you go, bro. You're taking panels off the thing, the command center down there.
What if you get, like,
orange blinkers, so because nobody has an orange blinker.
Yeah, everybody be ripping off your bike for their orange blinker. No one rips off your bike for a sticker. Right? Right. All you have to do is shine a light on it and it reflects.
Hey, I have.
Wait, other than that, who wants to run around in a candy cane colored bicycle, right? That
no, you don't want a fucking color. No, I'm saying like a...
I know.
No, the
car. Dougie, you're on Tuesday. You're working with Jed for from now till year 200. Dougie doesn't show because he got a good whatever he got that morning.
Yeah.
Okay, you have a third person waiting in line or a fourth in case you both don't show. Yeah.
Maybe someone, like,
a backup. So you have like, okay, just like when you line up for a bed, the first so many get in for sure. Then the guy hopes that the one guy goes for a smoke or whatever it is and doesn't come back. Boom, he's in. So you just have a.
So you're on the reserve board.
The what?
What about the coordinator?
Coordinator, we have a couple in mind that'll coordinate for a morning shift from 8 to noon. No.
8
what was
noon
it?
And noon till 8.
No, there was, no, noon to 4 and 4 to 8 or something. We had some crazy hours, right, where it would be a 4-hour shift, but they have two coordinators that coordinate it, and guess what, at the end of your shift, you get paid. All right, so you don't have to wait. It might be the after the morning shift, so there'll be a guy here from 8 to 4. We haven't quite worked that part out yet, but what we're doing is like we'll have somebody here that you will be paid, and we're trying to push for
24/7.
No, I want to get you into the realm of about $13 an hour.
No, really.
Yeah, we could come a little later. Like see what we could do is noon to 4, and then that's it. Noon to 4 and 4 to 8. That was it. Sorry.
Where are the busiest times for movies?
But no, it doesn't any time of the day. People have dope in their hand. So noon.
All hours of day and night.
To 4.
Usually around 6.
And then 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. Okay. Now, what Fraser Health has done is we've had meetings with them about this already, right? And they said that we would try and pilot this. Right, what these hours and see what kind of stats we can produce if there's a need for it, and say, hey, look, we're like coming in after 8 and people are still dropping, we're trying to, you know, we're just getting run off our feet and whatever, right? But the thing is, then they'll say, okay, so now we need to know that maybe we do 8 to 12. And then,
Yeah,
but it's also, you know, you have to have a coordinator sitting there and then people out, right? Now, teams of two doesn't mean that we can have 5 teams. Hey, Jen. Okay, so, all right, so you and Doug show up, right? And there's four more people that show up that are trained to go. Boom, 2 more teams hit the street. And we say, this is your area, where you go, this is your area, where you go. So you're going to have 6 people all sitting down in the Wally Corners or whatever, right?
Yeah.
Well, there'll be ways we'll find out, right? There'll be spot checking and all sorts of things. But the thing is, hey, man, I don't know if anybody ever paid you $13 an hour to go help somebody.
That's what the coordinator's going to do, check them out, because you know they're just going to go anywhere and do whatever is going
to
be
dope. Yeah, well, you guys are trying to do that to me in Langley, and I caught you. Screw that. So
12.
That's $52 a shift.
That's all
right. Right? For 4 hours. That's more than minimum wage.
You have vacation pay with that?
Yes, you do. We're going to send you on a vacation in a box with no holes.
Are they going to make sure that people are actually like good at riding bikes and shit?
Don't care. Push the damn thing. Go on foot. If you guys don't want to ride a bike, take the backpack, go on foot.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I
you're not comfortable
like
riding a bicycle?
That's what I was going to ask.
I don't want to see anybody precluded that
but
wants to do this
at riding bikes, so.
To not be able to go and help. So if say, I don't know, you got a sore foot one day or whatever, or not, you know, all it is, if I mean, hey, I'd flip the keys to my car, but I probably wouldn't get it back.
you
but you know what I mean?
Back,
if you want to walk instead, great, okay. Fine. All right, so that's the Spikes and Bikes program that we're waiting with bated breath and more news. And it's been a slow moving machine, believe me. When was our meeting when we have it?
When would we go to, like, mention it to them? Like, say it.
When was that
mention,
Jennifer?
Where?
Where?
We're
right here.
I mean, most of the people that are running it downtown.
Oh.
What if a bunch of us like just kept going there and saying we need one in 30? We need one.
No, we don't go downtown to Fraser Health Authority and saying this is what we need.
Yeah.
This is what we want to do. We're excited about it. We want to do it. Yeah.
A good area also would be up in Newton, like where all the work, you know, and that.
Well, they want to start it. We got to start small, right? We're going to start in our own little backyard. If it works, then we go, okay, now we can maybe do this. We could get one of the lookout vans to drop a team down in Newton, where we're at one in Guilford or wherever, and then in 4 hours, you'd be at this spot in 4 hours, or you're walking home, and then the van comes back and picks you up.
Unless you're on a bike.
So these two, doing harm reduction and recruitment as well?
Everything.
During the 4 hours? So
everything. So yeah, you'd be handing out rigs, you'd be handing out pipes, you'd be handing out whatever. Hey, it's like, what do you mean, man? I got a backpack full of it. As well as you would have a letter stating that you are not handing out drug paraphernalia and you're working with Sansi's organization, which works in conjunction with the Lookout Society, which works in conjunction with Fraser Health Authority. So it's the health authority who are really subcontract to do with street level outreach.
What
right?
if someone who has no parts gets robbed for like everything in the pack sack?
Come back and get a new pack sack and fill it.
What
the
if
place
they get
is
up or some shit?
Well, you know what?
There is people like
well,
that.
That's fine.
I would never let that happen.
Well, you know, no. Okay, if you're not, hold on. If you're not, most people are that I've ever been come to said, holy crap, I wish you were around a long time ago. Like
and I
say it's not just like it's, well it's not like I just come with one rig and one tie and one hooker. It's like here, take a bunch, you know, I'll fill your purse full, like, you know, and they go, what? You can give me all this stuff?
Yeah, I know. I almost shit my pants when I was downtown. I was working on Kingsway and Bitch. I never fucking knew they had that shit. And they come up.
Yeah.
That speaks to
the Sansi support. Right now, we have no funding. We have nothing. This meeting tonight is on my dime. I'm paying for everything in this room, except for you guys. Well, what do you want to do? Wash cars or steal them? It's easier to steal.
Well,
I know, guys.
Give a shit.
But all I'm saying is that. Right now, they're, you know, the Spikes on Bikes program, there's some funding in there. But what we need is, like, people, or they like to fund programs. Okay, so then, programs are what? A data collection source, right? That's a program. It's designed to collect information to make things better down the road, right? But with that part is administration. So this is the part that's lacking. Like, we don't have, they'll pay for the program to run, like the bikes and stuff, but they won't pay for the meeting that we're having right now to talk about it.
Does
that make sense?
What about just the end of your shift, you do a summary of...
Well, that's part of the program, and that's part of the data collection, but right now, like, say, okay, so we have regular Sansi meetings, right? To talk about, to generate ideas, to generate things that we want to do, to generate the talk about, you know, Bikes on Spikes, and if we had any other ideas, right? So we have, and so this is the part that the component that we're trying to push for. So it's like sustainability, right? Instead of going through the year like this, like, you know, why don't you just give us like a set amount of, you know, dollars, and then if you had a program, you only have to go from here to here. Instead of going from a program where we have zero all the way up to here, right? You see what I'm saying?
It's costing that though. Next
costing about $5,000 a day to run that.
Yeah.
And
you got four or six cops down there.
Yeah, it costs about $5,000 a day.
$12,000. How's that showing up in the overdose numbers?
Who said $5,000? What?
Costs about $5,000 a day to have those cops down there.
I wouldn't know it.
But
is that where it's going? Yeah.
What does
that
cost you per day?
Services.
Our numbers.
Say they hire two of the cops and then hire other people.
Well,
are you watching? You know,
the
spikes then.
Reversing the overload. I notice when the cops show up, they will challenge you for the job.
So reallocate sources,
so
right?
They kind of remove the safety factor.
So the money's all, some of the money's been there, but to reallocate the sources in an effective way, right?
Well, what they're doing, let me explain to you how that rotation works, is the government says, well, we're funding a program, but we're getting the RCMP to do the program. So the money that they're funding is going to the RCMP. All right. And that's why we got that big truck out there that's costing us $5,000, the taxpayer, $5,000 a day, to sit there and have 10 officers in there.
But when you need them,
no, we don't need them. We have us here.
Some people have been off there. There's nobody there to...
They're through us. That's how they're showing the numbers.
They're wanting to shoot someone.
Through you, Doug.
I know when an RCMP officer comes...
Through you, Doug. When every time you open your mouth, they're copping, tell them, I revived another one.
Yeah, well, they pull rank on you and send you off.
You know what? They can't do that. That's against the law.
Well, they do. I'm telling you. I said, I'm out there. Come on down. Come on down, watch. Sooner or later, you'll see that happen.
Alright.
Is there something new?
This is about funding.
Yeah, carpet, no.
No.
WAT.
No, medical arrows.
It's in Kamloops now. They're putting it on the pot and all that shit.
Yeah, okay, medical heroin, our medically supervised meth, or, you know, we already have dispensaries for weed. We all,
prescription heroin.
Et cetera. So do you turn it over to the medical community, like the pharmaceutical companies that'll give you pure heroin or pure, obviously there will be a little learning curve that you don't need as much pure heroin as you do as you thought you did, right? Because it's like pure stuff.
I think the government's trying to kill
everybody personally.
That's what they're ending up doing. I'll tell you the truth. That's what they're ending up doing.
My dad smoked a joint, and he fucking almost died. He's never done a drug. He said he was
standardize it and legalize it and take away the criminal element.
Yeah. I think you should legislate it.
Mm-hmm. Is that all right?
And regulate.
Right. Look what they did in Holland. I mean, Needle Park was like...
Needle Park.
That used to be the worst part of town. Now the kids are playing ball there with the family, and people are going in getting their...
Safe inhalation and using sites along that same
They
long.
Get it before, and then they go to work.
Do their heroin and they go off to work.
And it's like the stats prove that it's people, because it's legal, they're not going and doing it more.
Or crime. Isn't it funny, the little countries that participate in harm reduction full-heartedly, their crime goes down, you can unlock your doors, no one's going to rip you off because they're getting everybody to get what they want.
Yeah.
Right? I don't need to go break into your house because they're going to be for free.
We're big business though, you know?
Yeah. That's what they said, parents can keep their children too.
This is the way it should be going towards. They're behind. The government, the federal and provincial government, are both 6 years behind Sansu. It's a slow moving machine. It's like no one pays attention until.
A little white girl
in Maple Ridge overdosed of carfentanil or fentanyl pill in the Starbucks washroom. Remember that? She was like, 14 or something? A little kid in Maple Ridge, again, under a tree in a park. You know, a little white boy, you know, and middle class. Or a politician's daughter.
Yeah, I was just going to say, politician's daughter or son or fucking sister, then it matters, right?
Yeah,
Every family's got a black sheep or someone that's
It touches a lot more families than you think.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, there's a lot of cousins, you know, aunt or cousin, daughter, or whatever involved. Okay. So we touched on the naloxone kits, right? We touched on them and the fact that we talked about the kits versus
nasal spray. So pretty much, we're done. What do you think? Okay.
I think it's about time.
Okay, new people, what'd you think? Huh? Besides a boot in the face. Come to science and get your life punched out. That's when you get initiated into any gang. What'd you think?
Very informational.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Okay, the little poster, Brad, you want to pull the poster off the wall? So, show up, did you? Okay, just so you know what the posters look like.
I've already seen them.
That's what they look like.
I've seen them.
I love them.
Hey, before we end, is there anything else you want to talk about? Oh, I do. Okay, listen up.
I got a joke for those.
Listen up. Hey, last Sunday, one person in this room was on life support system and Sir Memorial Hospital, supposed to be dead. I called a meeting to do a eulogy and a wake tonight, but then he decided to show up.
Hey, got a champion in the
house. Huh? Hey, way to go, Brad. Way to scrub the Sansa meeting. Our first funeral, and you show
I'm
up.
I'm an overachiever. I can't help it.
Listen. In all seriousness, the stuff out there on the street right now, it's just going to get worse. There's carfentanyl. Next one's W18. Already here. Guys, already here. Okay? You know what W18 is about? It's about the size. If you have 80 grams, it's about the size of and weight of my phone. Okay, W18. If you buff this up properly, it buffs up to the size of a school bus. Dope. So guess what? You know why? Because I can do this and walk through the border and bring it into the country. And then it gets buffed here, right? So this stuff... Just think about it. Three grains of W18 will put you in the morgue.
Of course.
3 grains. How many grains are in a half a point or a quarter point or whatever?
I know, I was watching
it. It's just plain up kills you, man. You're dead.
There's no fucking
Narcan. Yeah, no, there isn't. By the time I walk from here to you, you'd be dead. Like, even to put one in you,
you wouldn't
make it. No more dying. God love. No more dying. You too, Jeff. Come on, you guys.
Yes, Jeff.
Yeah. Okay, everybody. At the end of our Sansa meeting, it's our. Hey, stop! At the end of our Sansa meeting, it's our tradition that, you know.
All right, let's get on with it.
And Stan, we have a moment of silence. Moment of silence for the people who have passed. So if you have a person in your life that has passed, just don't be afraid to shout out their name.
Car.
At this time.
Bill.
Bert.
Yeah.
Car, Steve, Bogarty.
Jeffy.
Jesse, Lisa.
Brad.
What's the Brad? Here's Brad.